Okay. On this first one right here, you have a tangent. So you should know that a tangent is 90 degrees. So what you're going to have is a triangle, and right here should be 90 degrees. So y will be 90 degrees. This one is already 20, and that's given. So you have to subtract from 180, which is the whole triangle, to get this one. This and this is 110, so this must be 70. These two should add up to 90. So 90 plus 90 is 180. Any questions on what I just said? When they add up to 90, it's called complementary. These two are complementary. All right, next. On the next one right here, I guess it's the same problem. Actually, no. Okay, sorry. What we have here is two tangents. So since we have two tangents, this one is equal to this one. Therefore, this angle is equal to that angle. So put an x here and here and put 40 degrees. So you're going to say x plus 40 is equal to 180. So 2x plus 40 is equal to 180. Subtract, so you get 2x equals 140, and then half of that is 70. So each of these has to be 70. It's an isosceles triangle because they're both tangent. Is everybody clear on that? We have two tangents, therefore these are equal, therefore the base angles are the same. So x and y are actually the same. The last one is a review, and that is trigonometry. So on this one right here, you put a dot and you label your sides. So if you didn't learn trig before, you're going to have to learn it, okay? So this one's opposite, this one is adjacent, and this one is hypotenuse. Now you look and you say, so, cotoa, okay? Well, opposite over hypotenuse is sine, so it's going to be the sine of 20 degrees is equal to opposite over hypotenuse. Any questions on what I said or what I did on that problem? Is everybody clear? Thank you so much. Uh-huh. Alyssa, this is yours. I'll give it to you in a minute. On the next one, you're trying to get x. X is the adjacent and hypotenuse. That would be cosine. So it's going to be the cosine of 20 degrees is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. Okay, now you have to be able to work both of these. So this one is going to be 10 times the cosine of 20. And this one is going to be 10 times the sine of 20. And then you use your calculator. And that's a review problem. Is there anybody who has a question on the trigonometry? Is everybody clear on that? If you didn't learn trigonometry, the videos are up. You just got to put the time in it. Learn it. All right, or you can go to tutor. They have the honors kids that I'm sure know how to do it. All right, put away your bell work, please. On a new sheet of paper, write down the formulas. There's seven formulas. There's eight diagrams, but there's only seven formulas.
write down all seven formulas.
Okay, I'm going to give you about another minute or two. All right, I want to get this done so I can get you as much time as possible in that other work. So on number one right here, tell me the angle, Olivia. What's the formula? Angle what?
ABC.
ABC, good. Angle ABC is equal to what, Olivia? Do you know?
AC.
It's going to be arc. AC, it's this right here. So arc AC, good. Number two, give me the angle, Taylor.
Angle ABC is equal to half the arc of AC.
Good, half the arc of AC, excellent. Good, because the vertex is on the circle. Very good job. Number three, Frank, do you know number three? Give me the angle. ABC
is equal to AC, arc AC minus DE.
All right, arc AC minus arc DE, but there's something that's missing, do you know?
Oh, okay.
Divide by 2. Good. All right, number 4. All right, let's see who's number 4. Carson, do you know number 4? Angle what?
I don't know, but I know the range.
Okay. Parker, do you know number 4?
No, I'm writing it down right now.
All right, let's see. Elijah?
No, I don't know the angle.
All right, who knows this one? Does anybody know? Lenora?
I think it's angle BEA.
Angle BEA
is equal to half.
Half. Which arcs?
AB.
Joe, put it over there, please. Arc AB. What else? Plus.
Plus BC.
plus arc DC. All right, good. Number five. Riley, do you know number five? Excuse me?
I haven't got to.
Jacqueline, you want to give it a go?
Is it angle A, C, D?
A, C, D. A, C, D is equal to what?
I don't know.
All right. Caden, do you know?
Angle A, C, D equals
1/2. Okay, you want to put the bigger one first. So you want to say arc AD minus arc BD. Not bad, but you want the big number minus the little one. Very good. All right, the next one, number six. Who can give me the formula? Or let me see. Derek, do you know? Renee, do you know? No? Who knows the formula for number six? Anybody? Elijah?
4 times 5.
4 times 5 equals
x times,
2. X times 2. Please don't miss this one. That one to me is the easiest, okay? Follow the line. Very good. This times this equals this times this. All right, number 7. Who wants to try number 7? Does anybody know that one? Number 7. Nobody has an idea, yes?
Is it 4 times
4
plus x?
4 plus x equals?
Equals 5 times 8.
5 times 5 plus 3, which is 8. Excellent. Is everybody clear on what he did? He did the outside times the whole thing equals the outside times the whole thing. Is everybody clear on that? Now you got to be able to work it. But I just want the formulas right now. All right, the last one. Who can give me the last one? Anybody want to try? It's kind of similar to what he just said. Nobody knows? Okay, outside times the whole thing, which is x plus 3, equals the tangent squared. Okay, you got to know all 7 of these when you take your test. And since we're off Monday, I guess it's going to be on Wednesday. If you cannot give me the formulas for all 7, I'm not going to grade your test. It's just that simple. Okay? If you don't know them, I'm not going to waste my time and grade it. I'm just being upfront with you here. I want you to finish 11.5 so you have the rest of the period.